In this lecture, I am going to explain one of the classification of solutions are based on solubility. Okay? Generally, based on solubility, solutions are classified into three types. One is unsaturated and saturated, and one more is supersaturated solutions. Okay? So, first look at what is mean by solubility. Okay? So, the amount of solute dissolved in particular solvent, okay, 100 grams of solvent, generally we are taking that as reference, to form a saturated solution. Or we can also define like this: the maximum amount of solute that can be dissolved in a particular quantity of solvent to form a saturated solution. Okay, at particular temperature, at pressure, we can also take that. Okay, this is a simple definition of solubility. So here too, easy to understood, the based on the solubility, how we are classifying which is unsaturated and which is saturated, which is supersaturated solutions, we are saying that. Okay. So generally you can observe that, particularly when you are taking that, one beaker I am taking, okay, here two understood easily I am taking as a three beakers. In the three beakers I am taking a particular amount. Okay. So to compare the three solutions, I am taking as a particular solvent in the particular amount. For example, water I am taking that 100 grams of H2 or 1 liter of H2, you can consider that. So in these three, I am taking that 100 grams of H2. Okay. So now I am going to add some X amount of solute. Okay. So X amount of solute. Here the solubility varies, that the nothing but it is must be depends on the solute. For example, you are taken as in a beaker. Okay. So in a beaker, it is containing some 100 grams of water. Okay. For that, I am adding some salt. Okay. So what you can observe that when you are adding the some small amount of that solute, nothing but a small salt we are adding for this one, it is easily dissolves in this one. Again, I am adding some amount of this salt again. Again, it is going to soluble in this one. Okay. It will be going to dissolve in the water. So like that, based on this one, for example, I am adding that 10 grams of solute. Okay. So 10 grams of solute I am going to add here. So this solvent has a maximum capacity to dissolve is a 10 grams. Just you can assume that. So when you are adding the 10 grams of solute, it is completely going to dissolve. Okay. So it's a maximum capacity, it can be accommodate that solute in 100 grams of solvent, how much 10 grams of solute is going to accommodate in 100 grams of water. So for example, when I am adding this 5 grams, okay, 5 grams of solute are now adding this. So how much of the maximum capacity for this solvent, it has in a 10 grams can easily accommodate here. But now how much I am adding that, 5 grams. So the remaining 5 grams is also, is that possible to add or not? Yes. Okay. So this type of the solution, whatever the maximum capacity, it has a maximum capacity can accommodate 10 grams. But I am adding that 5 grams. So that nothing but a solution which is containing less amount of solute, less amount of solute than that maximum amount of the solute. Those type of the solutions usually we can call that unsaturated solution. Got it? So that simply here I am saying that it has a maximum amount, it can accommodate easily 10 grams easily dissolves in this one. This is a maximum capacity. But now how much I am adding here? Only 5 grams. So which has the lesser amount of solute, okay, than the maximum amount of this one, the type of solution usually we can call unsaturated solution. Okay. So for this, now I am adding that, okay, easily now I am adding 10 grams. So the 10 grams of solute now I am adding for this solution, okay. So it is containing that how much of is the maximum capacity to accommodate 10 grams. So here also we are adding the 10 grams, okay, got it. So total, the maximum amount of the capacity is totally we are adding. Okay, so which is, that's why we are given that the amount of solute dissolved in 100 grams of solvent to form a saturated solution. The saturated solution can hold that the maximum capacity. So here the maximum capacity I am saying that maybe 10 grams. Okay, one of the solute 10 grams of maximum capacity, it is accommodating the 10 grams. So this type of the solution we can add the saturated solution. Sir, if I am adding that 15 grams. Okay, so generally here we get that a confusion. When we are adding that a 10 gram, the maximum capacity, you are saying that saturated. For example, if I am adding that a 15 grams. So in the 15 grams, when you are adding for this one, okay, So when you are adding that 15 grams for this solvent, so what happened? Some amount of solute can appear as a crystals in this one. Yes or no? So the 10 gram is going to dissolve in this one. 10 gram of solute is dissolved in a particular solvent. The remaining 5 gram is not going to dissolve in this one. It is appeared as a salt in this one, not like the crystals. Okay. So now here, this type of the solution is also we can call it saturated. Okay. So here what happened? There is a dynamic equilibria is formed between the solute and dissolved. So here the what is the maximum capacity solute? 10 gram is a solute one is there. Okay. So 10 gram is dissolved in this one. The remaining 5 gram is undissolved. So for example, here one of the particle if is enter into this solvent, okay, then what happened? One of the solute particle must be accommodated in this position. So there is an equilibrium is taking place. The 10 gram is solved, 10 gram is dissolved, 5 gram is undissolved. If one of the gram is dissolved in this, enter into the solvent, the particle which is in that already in solvent, it is coming into that undissolved state. So there is a dynamic equilibrium is taking place. So this type of the solution is also we can call that saturated solution. Saturated solution. If you are adding that more quantity, okay. So for example, if I am adding that 15 grams here. If I am adding that 15 grams here. So then what happened? Here again, 10 gram is on the maximum capacity. The remaining 5 gram is undissolved state. So for this type of solution, if I am giving that heat, okay, if I am giving that heat from that outside, so what happened? Nothing but the temperature is going to increase. These are the particular temperature, 27 degrees centigrade, 27 degrees centigrade I am taking. But now here I am going to increase in some amount of the temperature. For example, if I am taking as a 37 degrees centigrade, nothing but we are giving the heat from that outside. So what happened? This 5 gram is also going to dissolve in this one. Okay, this 5 gram is also going to dissolve in this one. This type of the solution usually we can call supersaturated. This supersaturated usually it is a metastable. Okay, it is in a metastable one. Metastable is nothing but when you are giving that heat for this solution, this undissolved solute is going to dissolve in the solvent. But when you are removing the temperature, so what happens? Slowly the temperature is going to down. So whatever the dissolved particles are there, again it is going to appear as an undissolved particle. So that's why I use the word as a metastable. Okay, that simply you can understood the terms of saturated, unsaturated and supersaturated. So the maximum amount, okay, the maximum amount which can be accommodated, okay, that usually we can call that as saturated. But which is the lesser amount when compared to the maximum amount, that usually we can call unsaturated. Okay, so when you are giving that increasing the temperature, it is going to soluble. Again, when you are removing the temperature, again it is appearing as an undissolved state. Those usually we can call super saturated solution. Got the point? So unsaturated, saturated, and super saturated solution. Clear?